हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर पी आर चौधरी फ्रॉम के केवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक। टुडे वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट स्पाइसेस एंड कॉन्डिमेंट्स। इंडिया हैज़ डाइवर्स सॉइल एंड क्लाइमेट एंड दिस हेल्प्स इन कल्टिवेशन ऑफ वेरियस डिफरेंट स्पीशीज ऑफ स्पाइसेस एंड कॉन्डिमेंट्स। इन इंडिया स्पाइसेस आर कल्टिवेटेड ऑलमोस्ट इन ऑल स्टेट्स एंड डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ कंट्री। Spices usually have low volume but high crop value. That means little amount of spice will cost you more as compared to other agronomical crops. Spices play an unique role in India's economy by improving the income of rural people. Rural India can get employment by cultivation of different spice crop and their processing. It is labor intensive, so it generates employment opportunity in rural population. Demand of Indian spice is high in different countries and there is scope to meet this demand by huge production. So exporting spices and condiments to other countries can help to generate more revenue and foreign exchange for India. There are other points also which make cultivation of spices important. Example, no other country grows as many spices as India. So India is cultivating largest number and different kinds of spices. It is traditional and largest producer, consumer and exporter of spices. In fact, the East India Company and other travelers came to India in search of spices. Even Columbus tried to come to India in search of spices, but he landed up in America. India is known as the spice bowl of world and land of spices. Almost 90 to 95% of the spices which are grown in India are actually consumed locally. So we are exporting only 10 to 5% of the spices. India contributes to 20% of the world spice production and 30% of the total spice trade. Spices are required in India for daily cooking of food, and most of the spices also have potential medicinal value. Example, we know that turmeric has anti-cancer properties as well as antifungal, antibacterial properties. It is also used in cosmetic and perfumery industries, example soap, toothpaste, creams, etc. There are certain constraints also in cultivation of spice crops like low farm productivity and high cost of production. So in India, we are not having high productivity in spice cultivation. We are not getting high yield per unit area, and that leads to high cost of production. So if we increase the productivity, we can try to reduce the cost of production. Non-coverage of high-yielding varieties in farmers' field. So there is still scope for developing high-yielding varieties and making these varieties available to the farmers in order to increase the production and productivity. Another problem is non-availability of quality planting materials of high-yielding varieties. Planting material mean different propagating materials which the farmers can use, like cuttings or grafting, etc., or rootstocks. So their non-availability is leading to less yield. Crop loss due to severe disease and pest incidents. We all know disease and pest incidents affect the quality as well as yield of the produce. So research needs to be done to reduce this loss. There are poor post-harvest handling procedures in case of spice processing and storage. So post-harvest handling has to be improved, and there is inadequate extension work. Meaning, whatever research is being carried out in the agricultural universities or research station, this needs to be given to the farmers. And even though the farmers are having high production, there is problem of price instability. So we are not having continuous price or constant price being offered to the spice crops. Furthermore, there are stringent food laws by importing countries. So we have to keep in mind the different laws before exporting our produce to different importing countries. Mycotoxin contamination also affects export potential. Mycotoxin means the fungal growth occurring on the spices or any other microorganisms producing mycotoxins or toxins affect the export potential of the spice crop. And then there is again stiff competition from other countries who doesn't have domestic market. We saw that in India we are consuming 90 to 95% of the spices what we grow, but that may not be the case in other countries. Example, in China, they may not be eating that much spices, but they are cultivating it and therefore exporting more quantity to other countries. Let us now look into different classification of spices. First, we can classify the spices on basis of their life period. Annual, meaning they complete their life cycle within one season or within a year. Example is your cumin or coriander. Biannual, like onion and garlic, which take 2 seasons or 2 years to complete their life cycle. And perennial crops like cardamom and clove, which are perennial trees. Spices can also be classified on basis of their growth behavior as herbaceous. Example is your cumin, coriander and fenugreek. Shrubs like cardamom, climbers like black pepper, and trees like cinnamon, clove and nutmeg. On basis of importance, they are further classified into primary spices and secondary spices. Primary spices are the spices which we use daily and in more quantity. Example, we use chili powder, chilies, turmeric and ginger in higher quantity and daily. Whereas secondary spices are used usually in less quantity or less frequently. Example is your cumin, coriander, clove. Spices are further classified on basis of the plant part used. Example, seed spices is cumin and coriander. In fruit spices, we have chili and kokum. Flower spices, we have saffron because we use the stigma of the saffron flower. In bud spices, we have clove, which is an unopened bud, unopened flower bud. In bark spices, we have cinnamon. Leaf spices include coriander, fenugreek and bay leaf. Fenugreek leaves on drying known as kasuri methi. Underground rhizomes, we have turmeric and ginger. And in bulb species, onion and garlic. Spices can also be classified based on their utility as taste imparting spices like chili, onion and garlic, or fruit spices like cardamom, cumin and coriander. Under botanical classification, we have monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Monocotyledons include family Gingiberaceae, which has ginger and turmeric, Aliaceae, which includes onion and garlic. Whereas in dicotyledons, we have different families like Umbelliferae, Cruciferae, Solanaceae, Piperaceae, Myrtaceae, Myristicaceae, Lauraceae, Rutaceae, Papilionaceae and Iridaceae. Based on the photoperiodic requirement also, you can classify the spice crops as short day plants, example onion, or long day plants like garlic and chili, and day neutral plant like capsicum and basil. So this was short overview about the different spices and condiments. Thank you.